Right, welcome to lecture series on mechanisms. We are in part 2 of module 1. We will start with lecture number 1. So previously in the first part of the module, we started with the basic definitions of what is a mechanism, what is a machine and what is a structure. And we explored the various terminologies with respect to the mechanism, such as a link, pair, joint, chain, etc., degrees of freedom, so many other things. And also we were able to explore the inversions of a single slider, double slider, as well as a four bar mechanism. Now coming to this chapter, we will explore the library of mechanisms. In a library, you find books written by many of the prominent people. So in this unit or in this part of the module, we will explore the mechanisms designed by various kinds of people for the problems that they faced in their daily life, right? So most of the mechanisms that we study in this chapter, they belong to the lower pair category. They consist majorly of turning and sliding pairs, right? So it is an elementary task. So most of the mechanisms we will be studying with respect to construction as well as the working principle. And what is the possibility, where we can find the application in our daily life? That is what you can explore on your own. Right. So moreover, studying of this mechanism will definitely help us in the further analysis as well as the design of mechanisms. Right. So now, one of the type of motion, right, I want to generate using a mechanism is a quick return motion mechanism. So we will quickly explore what is a quick return mechanism and why it is required. So coming to any metal cutting operation, we know that the metal is cut only in the forward stroke, right? Let me say, when I move from left to right, the material is cut and more time is taken. But when the material comes back to the initial position, right, when it returns to the initial position, the material is not cut. To increase the production rate, to be more productive, what I can do is, in the cutting stroke it should take more time, but if it can come back as quickly as possible to the initial position, then it saves time for me, right? So mechanism that generate quick return motion, we call it as a quick return mechanism. So machines such as power driven saws and the shaper machines employ this quick return mechanism to generate a quick return motion, right? So there are various kinds of quick return mechanisms. One is called as a drag link mechanism, Whitworth mechanism, and a crank and slotted lever mechanism. So in this lecture we will focus on drag link quick return mechanism, and in the subsequent lecture we will explore Whitworth as well as the crank and slotted lever quick return mechanism, right? So coming to the drag link mechanism, you can observe the animation here. On the left hand side you find a four bar chain. It is simply nothing but a four bar chain wherein both input as well as the output crank, link 2 as well as link 4, can complete 360 degree rotation. If output of such a 4 bar mechanism is connected to a tool via a link, so that consider that corresponding link is called as 5 here, then that produces a quick return motion. So if you observe here, when you move from H to I, that is the cutting stroke, it takes more time left to right. But when it has to move from right to left, you observe that I to J, it comes back as quickly as possible. That's the quick return we are talking about. It cuts the material from H to I, I to H, it comes back to the initial position so that it is ready for the next cutting stroke. That's the drag link mechanism. We will explore the construction as well as working of the drag link mechanism. So from the construction viewpoint, it's very simple. There is a link 1 which is fixed, we call those points as A and D. There is a link 2 which can complete 360 degree rotation. Link 3 is a coupler which connects 2 and 4. 4 is the output crank, again which is capable of making complete 360 degree rotation. So this is a normal 4 bar chain with point A, B, C and D. Now I will consider C as the output from the 4 bar mechanism, and I connect that point C via link number 5 to a tool. This is the tool I am talking about, which removes the material, right? So now that I am going to call that tool as E, the position of the tool or this current position as E. So this is the construction, as simple as that. 1 is a ground, 2 is a crank, 3 is a coupler, 4 is an output crank, 5 is a connecting link to the tool, and 6 is to the tool itself. So these are the 6 elements that are involved in the mechanism from the construction viewpoint. Now what is that I can appreciate here is that both link number 2 as well as link number 4 are capable of completing 360 degree rotation. I have shown the path traced by point B as well as the point C. That is what we have shown here, right? So coming here, we will explore right? So this is what I am going to call it as a stroke. Let me consider this as one of the extreme end, and let me consider this as one of the extreme end, right? So the distance between these two where the tool travels, we will call it as the stroke, right? So if it moves from left to right, so this direction, I am going to call it as the cutting stroke. When it moves back, I am going to call it as the return stroke. Right. Now the return stroke should happen quickly when compared to the cutting stroke. That's the logic behind a drag link mechanism. Right. Now, when for the given configuration, the tool is at position E. Now to analyze the quick return, what I want to do is I want to move E to E1. Right. So to move E to E1, what are the changes that I have to make in the drag link mechanism? So I have a point B. When point B moves to point B1, similarly, when point C moves to point C1. C moves to C1, B moves to B1, correspondingly E moves to E1. So this is the initial position that I am going to take to analyze the quick return motion mechanism. Currently, the mechanism is at E1 and it is ready to return back to begin the cutting stroke. It is not whatever that if the mechanism is going to generate the motion now, if I am going to generate the motion immediately, it will be a return stroke, not a forward stroke, right? So it has to move as quickly as possible. Now the current position is B1, current position is C1, and current position is E1. B moved to B1, C moved to C1, E moved to E1. Now E1 is my current position. Now if I move C to C1, right? So this is what I have. Now in the next stroke, what I do is, now when I come back here, I know that B moves to B1. So this is the current position I am in. C moves to C1, right? And E moves to E1, right? This is the current position I am in now. Now when the C moves to C1, right? Let me say, now the mechanism is going to rotate in the anti-clockwise direction, and C moves to C2, correspondingly, I was at point B1, I am still at point B1. When the mechanism begins to rotate, B moves to a new point, B2, in this direction. When B moves to B2, so you can observe two lines here. This is the line for B1 and this is the line for B2. Right? When B1 moves to B2, it travels through an angle beta. Right? So E1 now has come back to E2. Right? And it has completed the return stroke by traveling through an angle beta, right? So now I am at E2, right? Now B to B1, C to C1, E went to E1. So this is my starting position, right? So now C came to C2, B1 came to B2, and correspondingly E1 came to E2. Currently, I am in E2 now. I want to again go back to E1. If I do that, E2 to E1 gives me the cutting stroke. It should take more time compared to the return stroke. So how to do that? So C2 to C1, right? Again, in this path to complete the 360 degree rotation. So C2 comes to C1. Again, observe carefully here. B2, right? So B2 comes to B1 in this path. B2 travels to B1. When B2 travels to B1, it travels or by an angle alpha. So cutting stroke travels by an angle alpha. Now, if you observe the angle beta as well as alpha, we find that the angle alpha is greater than angle beta. This alpha becomes greater than beta because of the geometrical construction of the mechanism, not by any other means or not by any other reasons. By purely because of the geometrical construction, I find that alpha is greater than beta. Alpha indicate angle of cutting stroke. Beta indicates angle of the return stroke, and we find that angle alpha is greater than the angle beta, and it indicates that this particular mechanism generates a quick return mechanism, or it generates a quick return motion. That's the idea behind the drag link mechanism, as simple as that, right? So E1 to E2, it consumes less time in the return stroke. Right? E2 to E1 in the cutting stroke or the forward stroke, by traveling through an angle alpha, it consumes more time, right? The one that you see in the black color was the original configuration. One that you find in the blue color is the position number one, where I moved myself to one of the extreme end for the proper analysis, and red indicates the next position, what you have seen. So this is the animation. Again, you can observe carefully here, right? H to I is the cutting stroke, takes more time. I to H, as quick as possible, right? So that is called as a return. So H to I, it travels through an angle alpha. I to H, it travels through an angle beta. And one of the prime thing that we have to remember in a quick return mechanism is that always alpha should be greater than beta, and that happens only because of the geometry of the mechanism, how I construct the mechanism, not by any other reasons, right? So that's the end of lecture one. In the subsequent lectures, we will take up the remaining quick return mechanisms. Thank you.